In the previous section, we have completed FOP 6, 605 to 613, Generation 2. Now we will learn about MFPX, Generation 4. Pre-start checks. Check the EPC is correctly programmed. Check that the separator is correctly assembled. Check the system valves. Power supply. With new installations particularly, pay attention to the supply. Are the voltage and frequency correct? Click the isolator on the starter box. Open EPC door. Click on power button in top left. Check the air supply. 6 bar is normally required. Check the water supplies. High or low pressure. Check the brake. Is it off? Check the lubricating oil for the drive. This should be between half and two-thirds of the glass before starting. See your instruction manual for the type of oil to be used. Starting the ALCAP system. Start the feed pump from the pump starter. Watch the pressure gauge to ensure flow is established. Click the pump starter. Switch on the heater from the EPC 400. Click the button. Start the separator. The ampere meter will rise to a high value. Click the starter. Listen and observe. Ensure the separator is at full speed. The ammeter will come down to the normal running value. You can now click the Alarm Accept button and step through the list indications. Now the process should be started. The EPC enters the start sequence. The first stage of this is parameter 50, the closing of the bowl. Closing water is applied to the bowl. MV16 is activated. If the Alarm Accept button is pressed once at this time, the display should show the timer parameter 50 counting down according to the parameter setting, if P90 equals 1. The oil is still recirculating around the heater. Click Alarm Accept button. Next is the addition of conditioning water, parameter 52. This is to keep the sludge moist and thus help with discharge. This timer runs for 60 seconds. MV10 opens and water goes into the bowl. The pressure gauge in the outlet should show a pressure of about 0.5 bar. Next, the oil feed valve changes position and oil is fed to the bowl. This is a stabilizing period for the transducer. The bowl fills with oil and cleaned oil is discharged by the pairing disc. A back pressure is established in the clean oil outlet. The operating back pressure is set by the regulating valve, midway between the delivery height pressure, which determines the minimum back pressure, and the pressure required to overflow the bowl. The transducer reference is stored by the EPC 400 at the end of this timer. This timer runs for 120 seconds. It is considered good practice to check that the separator does discharge. This is done by pressing the discharge button on the EPC. This will be described in the discharge sequence. At the end of the start sequence, the program moves into the separation sequence. The length of the separation sequence is determined by parameter 1, which in turn is set according to the amount of sludge in the oil. P1 equals P60 plus P61. Most of the time is spent in the separation sequence. Unless the oil contains free water and sludge, nothing special will happen during the separation sequence until P1 is elapsed, at which point it enters the discharge sequence. The first stage of this is parameter 60, the minimum time between the sludge discharges. The second stage of this is parameter 61, the maximum time between the sludge discharges. We will first consider what happens when there is extremely low free water contamination in the oil. First part of separation sequence is parameter 60. This timer runs for 10 minutes, unless interrupted by trigger signal. Second part of separation sequence is parameter 61. This timer runs for 20 minutes, unless interrupted by trigger signal. At the end of this timer, the controller moves into the discharge sequence. When the maximum time between discharges, P61, has elapsed, the controller starts the discharge sequence by the addition of displacement water. We will now consider what happens when there is low amount of free water contamination in the oil. During the first part of separation sequence, parameter 60, there is no change in the transducer value. This timer runs for 10 minutes. During the second part of separation sequence, parameter 61, as there is some free water in the oil, it will be separated and the trigger point will be reached. This timer runs for 20 minutes, unless interrupted by trigger signal. When the trigger point is reached, the controller enters the discharge sequence at the beginning of P72. We will now consider what happens when there is more free water contamination in the oil. First part of separation sequence is parameter 60. This timer runs for 10 minutes. As the water fills inwards, the graphical transducer value should increase to the trigger point. When the trigger point is reached, the water level in the bowl has reached the disk stack. The water drain valve opens, and the water leaves the bowl slowly through the hole in the flow control disk. There is a slight drop in the oil back pressure when the water drain valve is open. There is a delay period after the trigger level has dropped below 100%, after which the water drain valve closes. If the trigger point is reached during P60, the opening of the drain valve is repeated. At the end of this timer, the controller moves into P61. Second part of separation sequence is parameter 61. This timer runs for 20 minutes, unless interrupted by trigger signal. There is some free water in the oil. This time the trigger point is reached. As the water fills inwards, the graphical transducer value should increase to the trigger point. When the trigger level reaches 100%, this is the point at which P61 is interrupted and the controller enters the discharge sequence at the beginning of P72. When the trigger point is reached, the controller enters the discharge sequence at the beginning of P72. Now go to the discharge sequence. Discharge sequence. At the beginning of every time discharge, that is when there is extremely low free water in the oil, displacement water is added to economize on oil losses. This timer runs for 120 seconds unless interrupted by trigger signal. MV10 opens and water goes into the bowl. The pressure gauge in the outlet should show a pressure of about 2.2 bar, slightly higher as water is being added. As the water approaches the disk stack, some water is detected by the transducer and the trigger level starts to rise. When the trigger reaches 100%, the addition of displacement water is stopped. Bowl opening water is then applied. If the trigger point is reached before the separation sequence timer has elapsed, then the discharge sequence starts with the opening water. It is not necessary to add displacement water, as the oil has already been displaced to the disk stack by the free water. The EPC must see the feedback signal, which indicates that a discharge has taken place. This facility is only possible with partial discharge bowls. The trigger point is reached. This timer runs for 1.0 seconds. When the pressure in the oil outlet line drops below the low alarm setting, the red LED for low pressure comes on. This is the discharge feedback signal, telling the controller there has been a discharge. The volume of sludge and water ejected is approximately 70% of the volume of the sludge space. The sludge space is from the edge of the disk stack to the edges of the bowl. In the MFPX system, P74, closing water, is now added after 5 seconds. In the next step, we are going to show P76, conditioning water. A small amount of conditioning water is added to help with the next discharge. This timer runs for 25 seconds. The pressure gauge in the outlet should now recover to 2.2 bar when water is being added. The new stored reference value can be higher or lower than the previous reference. If at any time the actual value of the transducer moves below the stored reference, then the reference moves and stays at this value. This timer runs for 30 seconds. The pressure gauge in the outlet should now recover to 2 bar. The reference time is a stabilizing period. At the end of this time, a new reference is taken and stored by the EPC. The trigger range is adjusted accordingly. Stopping sequence. This is a sequence of events which safely stops the separator. Initiate the sequence. The stopping sequence begins immediately after the sludge discharge sequence is finished. The controller enters the beginning of the discharge sequence. This has already been described. The only difference at this time is that the third LED from the top flashes yellow. This yellow LED is steady when the sludge discharge sequence is complete. Displacement water is added. This timer runs for 70 seconds. MV410 opens and water goes into the bowl. The recirculation valve has changed position. Oil is no longer being supplied to the separator. Displacement water is being fed into the bowl. It pushes out the oil remaining in the bowl. The motor is then stopped. Separator motor has been stopped. This timer runs for 180 seconds. Oil is recirculating. Stop the heater from the EPC. Make sure that the oil temperature drops. The brake should be applied once the EPC displays off. Is the temperature falling? Stop the feed pump at the starter. When the separator has stopped, release the brake. Restart the separator for 20 seconds to empty the bowl of remaining liquid. Close system valves as necessary. Click on the highlighted parts to get the operational. Initiate a discharge. Temperature readout. Water supply pressures to the valve block. Whilst most installations do not have specific pressure gauges, you should be aware that the system will malfunction if pressure is lost. Water supply pressures to the valve block. Whilst most installations do not have specific pressure gauges, you should be aware that the system will malfunction if pressure is lost. Air pressure. Air pressure of 6 bar is needed to operate the valve actuators. Oil temperature. This can either be checked on the EPC if a PT100 sensor is fitted or on a local thermometer. Gearbox or spindle drive oil level. Gearbox or spindle drive oil level. Flow indicator. It is a simple indicator and not a flow meter. This gives an indication of the flow rate to the system. Back pressure. The minimum value of this back pressure will be dependent upon the delivery height. The operating back pressure is set by the regulating valve, midway between the delivery height pressure and the pressure required to overflow the bowl. Some early systems were supplied with a flow switch instead of pressure switches. In such cases, there may not be a pressure gauge or a regulating valve. Motor current.